All right, explain how DNA relates to the Cambrian explosion and what we're talking about.
Well, right, I used to ask my students a question, and if you want to give your computer a new function, what do you have to give it? And they'd say, well, code or instructions or software or information, and all of those are correct answers. And it turns out that the same thing is true in life. If you want to build a new form of life from a simpler pre-existing form of life, you need new information, or rather, to put it more precisely, the evolutionary process would need to generate new information, new code. And that raises a big question. How does it do that? How would it do that? How could it do that? And one of the reasons that's such a big problem, a big question, is that the mechanism, the evolutionary mechanism, the driving force of the evolutionary process is thought to be natural selection acting on random genetic mutation, changes, random changes in the arrangements of A, C's, G's, and T's, the digital characters in the DNA molecule. Mm-hmm. But what we know from experience, experience of computer code, for example, is that if you start making random changes to digital characters in a message-bearing sequence, you're going to degrade the information that's present in that sequence long before you're ever going to generate something fundamentally new and useful. I mean, just ask yourself a question if you're a computer programmer. If you've got a functioning computer program and you start randomly changing zeros and ones, are you going to generate a new program or operating system, or are you going to introduce glitches and bugs into the program you already have?
Yeah, all our techies in the room are saying, keep the bugs away.
Yeah, keep the bugs away. And so there's something fundamentally disquieting from the standpoint of information science about the idea that random changes in a functional section of code or text could generate something fundamentally new. And so that's been a kind of general concern that scientists have had about the creative power of the Darwinian mechanism. Can the Darwinian mechanism of natural selection and random mutation really generate new functional code? Because to build a new animal, you need new code. You need new DNA with digital information stored in those molecules.